Welcome to Automation Anywhere Enterprise. Joshua manages the regional inventory for a chain of hardware stores, and he receives regular reports listing parts sold in each store. Unfortunately, these reports use a non-standard format, and currently he must manually copy the part information into an Excel spreadsheet before the inventory application can consume the data. This takes hours. Let's see how easy it is to automate this process. He must map the fields from the text file into the corresponding columns of the spreadsheet. Once he is able to complete the first line of data, he can repeat the process for the entire data set. Automation Anywhere Enterprise provides multiple tools for quickly creating bots to automate repetitive processes. One of these tools is the Task Workbench, a graphical user interface that simplifies the creation and modification of bots without the need for coding. The Workbench provides a rich set of built-in commands capable of automating the management of structured and semi-structured data. It understands document formats, such as an Excel spreadsheet, and provides built-in commands for manipulating data in these spreadsheets. Here, Joshua opens the spreadsheet into which he will copy the data. There are advanced options as well, such as handling password-protected documents. At the time, Joshua doesn't require this feature. Joshua wants to start filling in the spreadsheet beginning with cell A1. The Workbench provides a Go to Cell command for this task. Now that he has specified where in the spreadsheet he wishes to begin, he needs to identify the document that contains the text data that will be copied to the spreadsheet. The Workbench provides a built-in command for reading from a text or CSV document. He can simply drag it to the Workbench. His document uses a non-standard delimiter, and he can specify it here. If the document has leading or trailing spaces, he may trim them. Upon specifying the text file details, a loop is created and each line of the text file will be handled by each iteration of the loop. Note the helpful comment that tells exactly which variable will be used to store the values contained within the text file. This file data column variable corresponds to the column of data that will be copied from the text file to the Excel spreadsheet. To begin iterating through the rows of data in the text file, he must store the value in the A column of the spreadsheet. This corresponds to the part number. There is a set cell command for this. The cell value must be set to the value in the text document. He presses the function key F2 to get the list of available variables. He is looking for the file data column variable as specified in the hint. Joshua has successfully set the value of the first cell in the spreadsheet. Now he must set the second cell, B1. He simply needs to go one cell to the right to enter this value which corresponds to the part description. Now he will set the value in this second cell. He can repeat this process for all the items in the first line of the report. Note there are 6 fields of data for each line in the report. Since each field will be positioned in a different column within the spreadsheet, he will need 6 columns. He tells the Workbench to go to the third cell, C1, and set that cell to the value of the file data column 3. Once done, he will handle the 4th and 5th columns of data. Now he addresses the 6th and final column of data. Upon finishing this last column, he will have completed the first row in the report. He can use Workbench commands to process all subsequent rows by specifying where to go in the Excel spreadsheet. He'll just tell the Workbench to go to the row beneath the current row and to begin at the beginning of the row. That's it. Since the Workbench automatically created the loop, the bot will systematically walk through the text report one row at a time, processing each row of data and inserting the fields into the spreadsheet. Finally, Joshua needs to close the spreadsheet upon completing the processing. He has easily created a bot for handling this mundane, error-prone task. Now he can run his bot. Note the runtime window in the lower right. Within seconds, the task completes and the spreadsheet is finished. He can schedule this bot to perform this exercise on the files he receives weekly. As a result, Joshua has converted a time-consuming, error-prone task into an automated, error-free process. He has freed up time to perform more innovative and productive work. Enhance employee productivity, reduce errors, accelerate innovation. For more information and a free trial, contact Automation Anywhere.